Assalamu alaikum, dear viewers. We are discussing about assessment and management of acute headache. Headache can be symptom of many underlying pathologies, some of which may lead to severe disability and mortality. Red flag sign, systemic symptom and sign, which include fever, rigor, sweating, weight loss, history of immunosuppression and cancer. Neurological deficit, sudden onset, progressive headache, papilledema. There are many causes of sudden severe headache, such as subarachnoid hemorrhage, intracerebral hemorrhage, meningoencephalitis. Cerebral venous sinus thrombosis, CVST, idiopathic intracranial hypertension, hypertensive emergency, reversible cerebral vasoconstriction syndrome, posterior reversible encephalopathy syndrome. Subarachnoid hemorrhage. What are the causes? Secular or berry aneurysm, anterior communicating artery aneurysm, that is ACOM aneurysm 30%, posterior communicating artery aneurysm, PCOM aneurysm 25%, middle cerebral artery aneurysm 20%, polycystic kidney disease, artery venous malformation, AVM, vertebral artery dissection. Clinical features. History, sudden severe thunderclap headache, often occipital region, vomiting, loss of consciousness. On examination, the patient is usually distressed, irritable with photophobia, neck stiffness, focal neurological deficit, such as hemiparesis, aphasia, third nerve palsy, fundoscopy, may reveal subhyoid hemorrhage. On investigation, CT scan of head reveal hemorrhage in sulci or cistern. With there may be ventricular extension, negative CT does not exclude subarachnoid hemorrhage since small amount of blood cannot be detected by it. Lumbar puncture should be performed 12 hours after symptom onset to allow detection of xanthochromia. If either of these tests is positive, cerebral angiography is required to determine the optimal approach. This is CT scan of the head, which show blood in sulci cistern, and there is also ventricular extension. Now I am discussing about intracerebral hemorrhage. What are the risk factors? Risk factor include hypertension, vasculopathy such as artery venous malformation, amyloid angiography, cavernous hemangioma, coagulopathy, anticoagulant, blood dyscrasia, thrombolytic therapy, substance misuse such as alcohol, amphetamine, cocaine. The clinical presentation of stroke depends on which arterial territory is involved and the size of the lesion. The presence of unilateral motor deficit, higher cerebral function deficit such as aphasia, neglect or visual field defect usually places the lesion in the cerebral hemisphere. Ataxia, diplopia, vertigo and or bilateral weakness usually indicate a lesion in the brainstem or cerebellum. Findings that are suspicious for a vascular abnormality or lesion include enlarged vessel or calcification along the margin of intracerebral hemorrhage, associated subarachnoid hemorrhage, hyperattenuated dural sinus or cortical vein, disproportionately large surrounding edema and hematoma with an unusual shape and heterogeneous intensity. Patients with intracerebral hemorrhage who have lobar hemorrhage are younger than 55 years and have no history of hypertension benefit from MRI for identification of a secondary cause. Reduced conscious level usually indicate a large volume lesion in the cerebral hemisphere but may result from a lesion in the brainstem or complications such as obstructive hydrocephalus, hypoxia or severe systemic infection. The combination of severe headache and vomiting at the onset of the focal neurological deficit is suggestive of intracerebral hemorrhage. To detect hemorrhagic stroke, CT scan is the investigation of choice. After initial diagnosis of intracerebral hemorrhage, CT angiography, সিটি ভেনোগ্রাফি, এমআরআই, এমআর এনজিওগ্রাফি, এমআর ভেনোগ্রাফি আর কনসিডার টু ইনভেস্টিগেট দ্য আন্ডারলাইং কজ। ইন্ট্রাক্রেনিয়াল ইনফেকশন, হেডেক ইজ দ্য মোস্ট কমন অ্যান্ড ফার্স্ট ম্যানিফেস্টেশন অফ ইন্ট্রাক্রেনিয়াল ইনফেকশন কজড বাই ব্যাকটেরিয়া, ভাইরাস, ফাঙ্গাস, প্যারাসাইট। ইন্ট্রাক্রেনিয়াল এক্সটেনশন অফ প্যারানেজাল সাইনোসাইটিস অ্যান্ড অটাইটিস মিডিয়া মে রেজাল্ট ইন এপিডুরাল এম্পায়মা, মেনিনজাইটিস, সেরেব্রাইটিস অর অ্যাবসেস। ক্লিনিক্যাল ফিচার্স ইনক্লুড হেডেক, ভমিটিং, অল্টার্ড মেন্টাল স্ট্যাটাস, ফোকাল নিউরোলজিক্যাল ডেফিসিট, কনভালশন। অন এক্সামিনেশন দেয়ার মে বি সাইন অফ মেনিনজিয়াল ইরিটেশন সাচ অ্যাজ নেক রিজিডিটি, কার্নিক সাইন, বুডজিনস্কি সাইন অ্যান্ড স্কিন র্যাশ। ইমেজিং ইনক্লুডস কন্ট্রাস্ট এনহ্যান্স সিটি অর এমআরআই মে শো লেপ্টোমেনিনজিয়াল এনহ্যান্সমেন্ট ইন পেশেন্টস উইথ মেনিনজাইটিস। হার্পিস সিমপ্লেক্স এনকেফালাইটিস ইজ ওয়ান অফ দ্য মোস্ট ইম্পর্টেন্ট কজ অফ ভাইরাল এনকেফালাইটিস, হাইপার ইন্টেন্স এরিয়া অ্যাট ফ্লায়ার অ্যান্ড টি টু ফিল্ম অফ এমআরআই অফ ব্রেন অ্যান্ড অ্যাবনর্মালিটিস ইন টেম্পোরাল লোব, ইনসুলা অ্যান্ড ইনফেরিয়র ফ্রন্টাল লোব ইজ টিপিক্যাল। দিস ইজ দ্য এমআরআই হুইচ শো হাইপার ইন্টেন্স লেশন ইন দ্য টেম্পোরাল রিজন হুইচ ইন্ডিকেট হার্পিস সিমপ্লেক্স এনকেফালাইটিস। হোয়াট আর দ্য কমপ্লিকেশনস অফ মেনিনজিয়াল এনকেফালাইটিস? সেরেব্রাল অ্যাবসেস, সাবডুরাল এম্পায়মা, হাইড্রোকেফালাস, সেরেব্রাল ভেনাস সাইনাস থ্রম্বোসিস, সিবিএসটি। ম্যানেজমেন্ট অফ মেনিনজিয়াল এনকেফালাইটিস, ট্রিটমেন্ট অফ পায়োজেনিক মেনিনজাইটিস, অ্যাডাল্ট এজেড 18-50 ইয়ার্স উইথ অর উইদাউট টিপিক্যাল মেনিনজোকোকাল র্যাশ, সেফট্যাক্সন 2 গ্রাম আইবি টোয়াইস ডেইলি, সেফোটেক্সিম 2 গ্রাম আইবি 4 টাইমস ডেইলি। Patients in whom penicillin resistant pneumococcal infection is suspected, vancomycin 1 gram IV 3 times daily, rifampicin 600 mg IV twice daily. In patient who are age more than 50 years and in whom listeria monocytogen infection is suspected. This includes Benistem sign immunosuppression and diabetic or alcoholic. This group of patients are treated with ampicillin 2 gram IV 6 times daily or cotrimoxazole. And adjunctive treatment is very important in patients of meningococcal encephalitis. That is dexamethasone 0.15 mg per kg 4 times daily. Viral encephalitis, acyclovir 10 mg per kg body weight IV 3 times daily for 2 to 3 times along with anticonvulsant and dexamethasone. Now cerebral venous sinus thrombosis. What are the causes of cerebral venous sinus thrombosis? CVST. Systemic causes includes dehydration, pregnancy, Behçet disease, thrombophilia, hypotension, OCP. And local causes include paranasal sinusitis, meningitis, subdural empyema, penetrating head and eye wound, facial skin infection, otitis media, mastoiditis. Clinical features. Cavernous sinus thrombosis may present with proptosis, ptosis, headache, external and internal ophthalmoplegia, reduced sensation of trigeminal first nerve and papilledema. Superior sagittal sinus thrombosis may present with headache, seizure, focal neurological deficit, papilledema. And transverse sinus thrombosis may present with hemiparesis, headache, seizure, may spread to jugular foramen and involve cranial nerve 9, 10, 11. Investigation, MR venography demonstrate a filling defect in the affected vessel. D-dimer is elevated. This is the MRV of brain. MR venogram, it show filling defect in the left transverse sinus. Management, anticoagulation initially with heparin followed by rivaroxaban is usually beneficial even in the presence of venous hemorrhage. Management of underlying cause and complication such as persistently raised ICP is important. Idiopathic intracranial hypertension. There may be history of female gender, childbearing age, obesity, drugs such as OCP, tetracycline, lithium, vitamin A. Symptom, headache not responding to analgesic, arsenic of headache on supine position, visual change, nausea, vomiting. On examination, there may be papilledema, hypertension, bradycardia, and sixth-nerve palsy. Management includes avoidance of OCP, tetracycline, and weight reduction is very important. lumbar puncture to evacuate CSF fluid is as well as important. Acetazolamide along with potassium replacement is also given in patient of idiopathic intracranial hypertension. If these measures are failed, then lumboperitoneal shunt is advised. Hypertensive emergency. Symptom: headache, nausea, vomiting, visual change, confusion, seizure, oliguria, edema. History: pregnancy, medication, past history of hypertension, and underlying etiology of hypertension such as pheochromocytoma. On examination, there may be altered mental status, peripheral edema, sign of heart failure, renal bruit. Reversible cerebral vasoconstriction syndrome, RCVS. Reversible cerebral vasoconstriction syndrome is not a single disease, but rather is the end result of multiple abnormal processes that cause reversible vasoconstriction in the cerebral vasculature. RCVS may be a diagnosis in patients who present with a thunderclap headache, and its symptoms mimic those of aneurysmal subarachnoid hemorrhage. Headache usually starts posteriorly and may become diffuse over time. It is often triggered by sexual activity, exertion, Valsalva maneuver, emotion, postpartum state. Imaging is important to confirm the diagnosis of RCVS to exclude other causes such as aneurysmal subarachnoid hemorrhage or cerebral vasculitis. The key imaging feature of RCVS is segmental arterial vasoconstriction characterized as easting of beads pattern with alternating area of arterial stenosis and dilatation. Posterior reversible encephalopathy syndrome, PES. PES is seen in patients with preeclampsia or eclampsia, renal failure, hypertension, sepsis, alcohol withdrawal, and who take cytotoxic and immunosuppressive medication. Pathophysiology remains unclear. However, dysregulation of cerebral vascular tone due to sympathetic overactivity and subsequent endothelial dysfunction. Clinical presentation varies from confusion to status epilepticus, visual disturbance, hallucination, blindness if there is involvement of occipital lobe. Imaging: non-enhanced CT, low attenuation at cortex or subcortical area. Parieto-occipital area is the classical site of involvement. Atypical locations such as basal ganglia, cerebellum, brainstem may be involved. Intracranial hemorrhage such as subarachnoid hemorrhage, parenchymal hematoma, microhemorrhage can be seen in 15% patient. Contrast enhancement may be seen at leptomeninges. Carotid and vertebral artery dissection. Spontaneous craniocervical dissection occur in patients with underlying arteriopathy. Triggering factor: minor activities such as coughing, vomiting, or cervical manipulation. Headache is the earliest symptom. Pulsatile tinnitus is more common in patients with ICAD, whereas ischemic stroke is more common in patients with vertebral artery dissection. But ischemic stroke associated with ICAD is more severe. CT angiographic findings of vertebral artery dissection include irregularity, stenosis of the vessel, the string sign, double lumen, dissecting aneurysm formation, or complete occlusion. The pathognomonic crescent sign is seen classically at axial fat suppressed T1 MRI and represent an eccentric rim of T1 hyperintense subintimal hematoma surrounding a hypointense arterial lumen. Thank you all. Thanks for this video to visualize.